My artistic practice is very much based on being a person from the Caribbean, being a person from the Virgin Islands. We're a place that has been colonized seven different times. And so a lot of my practice is thinking about the materiality of the colonial experience. And I really try to think about ways to explore our history and our landscape, connecting the past, present, and future so that we can kind of figure out how do we move, how do we begin to own ourselves as we've been in possession for so long. For those of us who live at the shoreline, is inspired by so many things. When I would walk the beach, thinking about the Caribbean and its history, there are a series of plants that you see that are both holding in the soil and the erosion, and they're also nurturing it. And those plants might be like the sea grape or sea purslane or the manchineel, mangroves, which are super important for the ecosystem as well. I thought about how they could be kind of this metaphor for how do we navigate this history? How do we protect ourselves? What are the things that we need to let erode and wash away? And what are the things that we need to hold in and stay very rooted to? And so the title of the piece comes from the first line in a poem by Audre Lorde, A Litany for Survival, where she's thinking very much about people who come from histories of oppression. How do you survive that? And so I think that the piece is kind of doubly both dealing with body, but it's also landscape, because it looks like this really beautiful landscape, but at the same time, all of those plants, you know, some of them are even poisonous. You know, they all have their different function and their different role. They kind of help us to think through what are these things that we should be rooted in and hold on to, and what are the things that we need to let wash away. The Chaney series comes from these small shards of colonial pottery that you find that kind of just come up after it rains very heavily. They were brought over in the 1700s and 1800s during the colonial period on boats, and they become a part of the trash and part of the afterlife in some ways of the colonial period, but they're still there. They still keep resurfacing. So that the series is literally taking these fragments and piecing them together in a very intuitive way. I call them almost like process paintings because they're not planned out. They're very much, you know, looking at this piece where I don't know the rest of the petal or the flower or the pattern, but then I'm having to kind of imagine it. And I think it's very indicative of Caribbean identity in the way that we may not have our full African identity, European identities, indigenous identities, but we have these fragments and we have to kind of reimagine and create something new. I normally do separate paintings, but for this one, I decided to do the paintings kind of merged together. So some of them, they were created as diptychs and then they were separated and reorganized. So in a way, it imitates the same fragmentation process and then the reorganization. And what I love about it is that you'll look at them and there are all these kind of surprising connections that happen and reconfigurations. I lived a significant part of my life in New York and then I went back home to the Caribbean and kind of established myself as an artist there. And I think this is the first time I've had a solo project in New York. And so having it at Brookfield Place, it's really exciting for me. Many people, when they think about the Caribbean, they think about it as just this place of sun, sea, and adventure. And we're a much more complex place than that. You know, it is the place, in many ways, like New York, where it's a cross-section of many civilizations around the planet. And so what I hope is that when people see that, they can see the complexity of those narratives reflected in the artwork.